Hi teachers. Let's say you want to run a quiz. You want to pick a student at random. How would you do that in a cool way? You use the spinning wheel animation. You click on the button here and the wheel spins. And then you click again, the wheel stops, the number picked is 11, so you ask Kane the question. This can be a set of questions that you pick at random as well. There are a number of ways you can use the spinning wheel animation in your class. So let us see how to create this beautiful spinning wheel animation from scratch. The thing is, you can do this the right way or the wrong way. When you do it the wrong way, you end up creating something that looks like this. When I click here, you can see that the wheel is spinning all wobbly and it doesn't really look very professional. So I'm going to show you how to do it the right way. And also, I'll show you some simple tricks where you can save time in building this animation. So let us jump right in. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. The first step in creating the spinning wheel animation is to create the spinning wheel. So let us go to a new slide. Let me create the spinning wheel by inserting a chart. This time, I'm going to use a simple pie chart. The basic pie chart is just good. So let us say OK and we have got our chart here. Now we need to populate these numbers so we can create the number of segments we want. In our case, we want 12 segments. Let me click and drag this so we can extend this. Now I'm going to replace this with number 1. So let me write number 1. Now I'm going to move my cursor to the bottom right of the cell and let me click and drag to 13th row. Why 13 rows? Because we have a header row, so 13 minus 1 is 12, so we have 12 segments. The next step is to have labels. If you use these numbers as your labels, you will have only number 1 showing in each of those segments. That is not what we want. Instead, we want the numbers to be shown from 1 to 12. So let us create a new column and call it labels and then write number 1 here. And then move your cursor to the bottom right corner of the cell, but this time hold the control button and then click and drag, and you can see that the series is filling and we have 1 to 12 shown. Great. Now I can safely close this and you will have a beautiful chart here. Let me remove all the unnecessary elements here. We don't want the title, so let me select that and delete. We don't want the legends, so select it and delete. We want the data labels to show, so let me right click on the chart, go to add data labels. Now you can see that the data label that is shown is just 1. Instead, we need to have the numbers that we have written as labels. So how do we change that? You click on these numbers here, right click and say format data labels. Now you can see by default value is picked up for showing here. Now I'm going to uncheck this. I'm going to instruct Excel, which is now showing in PowerPoint, to show value from cells. So you check this option called value from cells, and then it will automatically show you where exactly you need to pick those values from. So let me click on this and you can see that we have the labels selected. So I'm going to click and drag. So I have all these 12 numbers selected. Perfect. And I'm going to click again and say, okay, now these are changed. Can you see here? We have labels shown from 1 to 12. Excellent. Let me close this. Now, while this is selected, I'm going to increase the font size after changing the font type. Let me go here and choose 2cent empty condensed extra bold, which is a thicker font. And let me increase the font size like so. Now, make sure that everything is clearly visible. If at any point of time you feel that the text is not clear, you can always change the font color. Now the numbers are beautifully visible. Now we have the pie chart with 12 segments. Excellent. I'm going to now cut this by right clicking and using cut option. Then right click on the slide and say picture, which is the second option. Now we have a picture available here. Now the next important thing is to crop this picture in a circular shape. So let me select this. Then go to picture format, go to crop to shape and say basic shapes, oval. Then go to crop and say aspect ratio and 1:1. Now you can see we have a perfect circle available for us. Now I'm going to hold the control button and shift button and click and drag from the corner so I can have this focused on just the pie chart area. Now we have got a perfect circle available. Brilliant, I can click outside, and this is a very important step for you to do. Most presenters try to paste it back as a WMF or EMF. They try to ungroup it, group it. I've done all kinds of experimentation. The simplest way to get the spinning wheel animation to work properly is to do it the way that I suggested, which is to paste it as a PNG picture or JPEG picture and then crop it in a circular shape. Now we have got this image the right way. Now we are going to apply spin animation to this one. Let me select the image, go to animations and say emphasis animation and spin animation. Now you can see that the spinning is proper. Then let us go to animation pane so you can see what we have done here. We are going to reduce the duration. If it spins slowly, then there is always a possibility of gaming the system. So we need to have this spinning fast. So let us reduce the duration to 0.5 seconds. And that works perfectly fine every time. Now, it is not enough if the wheel spins just once. It needs to keep spinning until the next click. So let us go to the drop-down menu of this animation event, go to effect options and say timing, and it needs to repeat until next click and say okay. Now you can see that the animation keeps happening till you click again. Now comes the most critical part. We need to have a better control of deciding when this wheel needs to spin and when it needs to stop. For that, we are going to insert a button that does the operation. We are going to create the button using a simple circular shape. So let us go to the auto shapes gallery, pick up the oval tool, hold the shift button down as you draw the circle and place the circle right in the center. I'm going to change the shape fill color to black color, go to shape outline and say no outline. The next step is to insert the symbol which says play and pause so people know what exactly to do with this button. Let me double click on this. Now we have the option to enter the text. Now we can insert the symbol. So let us go to insert, go to symbol, and let us go to webdings. Webdings is the font where you will find this option for play and pause buttons. So let me select this and say insert. Let me select this which represents pause and say insert and close. Now we have the symbols available. You can always increase the font size so these symbols are clearly visible. Now we have got even the button in place. The next step is to create the needle that will allow us to select the number. So let me go to Auto Shapes Gallery once again, go to Block Arrows, and I'm going to choose this option called as Arrow Pentagon. Let me draw the pentagon here and then click and drag this yellow handle so we can make this needle a bit sharper. And then let us adjust the size like so. And then I'm going to place this somewhere over here so that a part of the needle is now right in the wheel. Then let us change the color to red color. If you want, you can go to shape effects, go to preset and add a preset so it has a nice little shadow available. Now let us get back to the animation part and make sure that this spinning continuously happens only on the click of this button. Now for that, we need to have a way to recognize this shape among the various shapes available on the slide. For that, we are going to do a simple trick. Let us select this oval tool, go to home, go to select, go to selection pane and give this a memorable name. So instead of calling this oval 37, we are going to say play pause and then hit enter. Now this oval has a very memorable name. Now let us do the relevant animation. Now let us go to this animation event, click on the drop down menu, go to effect options and go to timing and say this spinning continuously needs to happen at the trigger. So go to triggers and say start effect on click off. When you click on the drop down menu, you will see this option here, which is play pause, which is the name of the circle that we have just entered. And let me select this and say okay. Now this spinning will start only on the click of this button. We need a way for the spinning to stop at the click of the same button. For that, we need to add another animation. So let us select the spinning wheel again, go to animations and then say add animation. And this time we are going to have appear animation added. And this appear animation again will be triggered on the click of this button here. So let me go to the drop-down menu, effect options and say timing triggers start effect on the click of the same play pause button and say okay. Now when I go to the slideshow, I can click on this and you can see that the spinning happens and it happens properly. There is no wobbling anywhere. and then I can decide the time I want to stop. Let me click again and it stops, and the number is 5, and I can have anything written here which represents the numbers from 1 to 12. Here I've copied the names from the previous slide, and I can keep playing this for as long as I want, and I can keep selecting the random numbers quite nicely and with a very good visual appeal. As I mentioned earlier, this tool comes in quite handy whenever you create an interactive quiz. But then how do you create an interactive quiz? There are two resources that are available which will come in quite handy if you're a teacher. One is a paid option called 45 Interactive PowerPoint Quiz Templates, which is available on our site. I will leave a link in the description box below the video. We also have a couple of other useful products for teachers. One is 25 Interactive Tabs Templates Pack, and we also have a Teachers Pack available, which is quite popular among teachers. If you want to watch a useful free YouTube video that shows you how to create an interactive quiz for yourself, then I've included a link to that video right here. All you need to do is to click on the link here and watch that video and learn how to create interactive quiz in PowerPoint like a pro. So go ahead and click on the link and watch that video right now.